Hey, how's it going, everybody? It's your bro here. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, we're going to be discussing hash maps in Java. And at the end of this video, we're going to be creating a hash map of countries and capitals, and we're going to be displaying it in a neat, organized table. So, let's get into it. Before you reach the end of this video, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe so that we together can challenge and defeat the mighty YouTube algorithm. What is going on, everybody? So for this video, we're going to be discussing hash maps. So hash maps are very similar to array lists. They store a series of objects, kind of like a normal array, but they're a lot more user-friendly. But the difference between a hash map and an array list is that hash maps can store key value pairs. So for example, what might come to mind is a name and an email. It's going to store a pair of information, a key value pair. So with a name, there's usually an associated email, or vice versa, or a username and an associated ID. And for the example we're going to be working on for this video, is that we're going to create key value pairs of countries and their associated capitals. So, in order to use a hash map, we need to import one thing at the top of our program. So we're going to type import java.util.hashmap. I don't know why, but saying hash map makes me think of hash browns. Now, to create a hash map, this is what we're going to type. We're going to type in hash map. Make sure to get the capitalization right. The H and the M are capital. Then we need a unique name for this hash map. So I'm going to call this countries equals new hash map parentheses semicolon. Step two is that next to the word hash map, we're going to add a set of angle brackets. And then we're going to list the data types of the information that we're storing. So if we're storing a country and an associated capital, we're going to store two strings here, and then make sure the S is capital. Now, if you're storing different data types, for example, an integer, well, these hash maps only store objects, so you need to use encapsulation. Whoa, hey guys, it's bro from the future here. So I actually made a mistake at this point. I wrote down need to use encapsulation. What I meant to write was need to use wrapper class. Encapsulation is something completely different from wrapper classes, and I tend to mix up those two. Encapsulation has something to do with privacy statuses, and wrapper classes, that's the concept of taking a primitive data type and converting it to an object. So when I say need to use encapsulation for this part, I meant to say need to use the wrapper class. That is all. Time to go back to the future. So for example, if you need to store a string and a value that's an integer, instead of writing int here, you would write the whole word integer with a capital I. If you need to store a double, you type in double with a capital D, or boolean with a capital B. So you get the idea. So we're going to store two strings, both have capital S, and then we're going to place this within the other set of angle brackets as well. All right, here is our hash map, and it's called countries. Now we want to place some key value pairs within our hash map countries. So I'm just going to add a note that says add a key and value. And in order to do this, this is what we're gonna type. The name of our hash map, countries dot put. Whoa, there we go. Not sure what happened there, it just freaked out. So countries dot put, and then we need two values to place within here. The first is going to be a country. So maybe for an example, let's type in USA. And for the second value, we will type in the capital of the United States, which is Washington, DC. Let's add a few more countries. So we're going to type in the name of our hash map, dot, then use the put function. Not sure why it keeps freaking out like that. And then we're going to add another country. How about India? And the capital of India is New Delhi. And just to save time, I'll copy these, but I think you get the idea. So maybe we'll add Russia, and the capital of Russia is Moscow, and China, and the capital is Beijing. Okay, we have our countries. Now we can actually display all the values, all the objects within our hash map. So all we need to do is type in system.out.println or just print. And what we're going to type in here is just the name of our hash map. All right, let's try it. So even though this is displaying all of the values, all of the key value pairs within our hash map, it's not too pretty though. So we're going to be formatting this later, but let me show you a few other useful functions for hash maps. So I'm just going to turn this into a comment for now, and let's start fresh. Now we can remove a country from our hash map. So we're going to type in the name of our hash map, so countries, dot remove, and then type in a key. So let's say that the USA goes rogue and they are no longer considered a country. All right, so we're going to remove the USA, and then we are going to display countries. So let's see if it's still there. Yep, and it appears that the USA is missing. So let me show you guys a few other functions. So we can also get a capital from one of these keys then. So we're going to type in the name of our hash map again, so countries, dot, and this one is get. And then we need to add a key here. So let's get Russia. Then I'm just going to get rid of this print line. Okay, so this doesn't appear to do anything. So what we're gonna do is put this within a print statement, because right now it's returning whatever the value is for Russia. So system.out.print or print line. And then within the parentheses, countries.get Russia. So this is going to return the capital of Russia, which is Moscow. Okay, moving on. So let's clear everything. So we're going to type countries.clear. And then we are going to display our hash map. So system.out.println countries. And let's see if all the countries are still there, which they are not. Everything's missing now. Everything's been cleared out. Okay, moving on. Let's display the country's size, the size of our hash map, how many key value pairs we have in here. So what we'll do for this is type in the name of our hash map, countries.size. And then we need to put this within a print line statement. I guess print or print line. And let me get rid of this for now. Okay, so this will display the size of our hash map, how many key value pairs are within here basically. And there are four. 1, 2, 3, 4. That is correct. Let's replace one of the values for a specific key, more specifically the USA. So type in the name of the hash map, dot, and we're going to use the replace function. So we need to specify the key. Let's replace the value for the USA. So we need to replace this with a new value. So let's say that President Trump decides that the new capital of the US is going to be in Detroit. And then let's display our hash map. So system.out.println countries. Yep, and the new capital of the USA is Detroit. Okay, I have two last functions to show you guys. So we're going to check to see if a certain key is within our hash map. And there is a specific function to use this or to do that. So countries, then dot, then we're going to use the contains key function. And we're going to look for a certain key to see if it's there. Let's check to see if England is in here. Now this returns a Boolean value, true or false. So if we were to have it just like this, this wouldn't appear to do anything. So let's actually display what this returns by putting this within a print statement. So system.out.print, and then just surround this function with a set of parentheses. So if England is a key within our hash map, it's going to return true. If it doesn't find it, it returns false. Now let's check to see if our hash map contains a certain value. So it's going to be very similar to what we had up here. So I'm just going to copy and paste this, but we're going to use the contains value function. And let's search for perhaps Beijing. So if this value is within our hash map, it's going to return true. If not, it returns false. But Beijing is a value within our hash map, so it returns true. Okay, so the last thing I'm going to show you guys is a decent way of displaying all the key value pairs within a hash map, and you can actually use a for each loop to do this. So this is what we're going to type. We're going to type for, then a set of parentheses, string with a capital S. We have to list the data type of what we're displaying, so string with a capital S. We'll use I for an index, then a colon, and then countries dot key set. So this will iterate once for each key within our hash map. And let's just display system.out.print I to begin with. And let's see what we have so far. Oh, let's make this print line. My bad. Okay, USA, China, India, Russia. So let's also display the value as well. So I'll just make another line for this. System.out. Maybe print line. Okay, if we want to display a value for an associated key, what we're going to type is countries.getI. And let's try it now. Okay. We're getting somewhere, but I'm going to make a few changes. We're going to change the first line to just print, and then I'm going to add, how about a tab? So we'll use the escape sequence for a tab character, plus maybe an equal sign, and then I'll add a space after. So let's check to see this now. And what we get is a somewhat decent looking table when we display all the key value pairs for our hash map. So that's the basics of hash maps. If you would like a copy of all this code, I'll post it in the comments down below and pin it to the top. And your assignment is to create a hash map and then display all of the key value pairs and then take this display and post it in the comments section. But yeah, that is how hash maps work in Java. Hey you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learn something new, then you can help me help you in 3 easy steps by smashing that like button. Drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.